Today we're going to take a look at LEDVANCE's Damp Proof IP65 range.
Trip down memory lane for me. Specced a lot of these.
You've got a long memory because you've been around for a long time, so where would you like to take us in that memory?
I mean, these are workhorse fittings of industry, seeming everything from water treatment, garages, anywhere where there's dust and you need a reasonable degree of protection from water.
Yeah, and I can see we've got this one out of the box and it's parts that it came with. But shall we take a look at how we got to this stage?
Let's have a look. Oh, so let's get into some unboxing. What I like about the box, nice picture of the product and all the specification data is on that label at the end, so you're not going to confuse it if you've got different variants before you get it even out of the box.
What I liked about the box, it only had the fitting in it and not some miscellaneous items that could get obviously lost.
Yep, that's highly likely.
Yeah, with me, you suggest. The clips are brilliant because they're on it.
Yes, I've seen a lot of these fittings where they might be plastic and they easily drop off, or you need incredible strength to get them off and to put them back on. And obviously these clips are important to keep that IP65 rating of this fitting.
Yeah, and to be in place on the fitting at the start's good, so I won't have to put them on myself. Pull the tray out of the way.
All right, got a bag of bits here.
Yeah, I'm going to bring in my new scissors.
I've had some
criticism in the past about my blunt scissors.
But we did, yeah, all right. Yeah. So let's
see what's in here then.
A bag. Some parts.
Yeah, so let's have a look, just open it out. These clips here are for both surface mounting and if you wanted to say hang it for something like a chain.
All right, okay, that's good.
Yeah, so there's two of those. Yep. We've got a couple of grommets, so if you want to blank out a hole for your gland, which you get two, the other gland is on the end. So if I wasn't going to use that when I took it out, obviously I've got a grommet.
All right, okay. And there's plenty of other cable entry possibilities in this fitting as well.
Yeah, I'll show you them as we go through. Let's have a look at these clips first. So if I was going to hang it, just put the little bracket in.
Okay.
Just like so, firmly held into position. It's done both. Hook those in. And it's really nice where they situate on the actual back of the fitting itself. So let's look at these holes first. I've got options to come in the centre.
All right, yeah.
Yep. Or the end.
All right, yep. End from the back or from the side entry. Yep.
Yeah, so all of those are possibilities. And you notice there the edge here where I'm going to put my actual bracket clip.
Right, okay.
Look at that.
Oh, wow, that was quick.
Yeah.
So you don't need to drill the fixture body at all to put your mounting brackets on.
No, so you aren't worried therefore about your IP65 and start drilling holes into it. If you want to add a security element to that, so anti-theft or anti-vandal, okay, we've got this bolt here and you can put that through and it'll grip it against the actual fitting itself.
All right, so you can't then take the bracket off the back of the fitting.
No, you can't, which is good. So that goes up and that will also require a torque setting.
All right, there is a torque setting. Yeah, more and more products we're seeing coming with torque settings on them. And again, for me, as they say, it's a sign of quality that the manufacturer's gone to the trouble of telling you this.
Yeah, so torque that one up. Where do you find the torque settings? Obviously, it's in the instructions. It's between 4 and 5 newton meters of torque, so that's a beefy torque setting.
Which you'd kind of expect on a bolt.
When we look inside the fitting itself, bit of quality again.
All right, so we've got some screwless terminals there. It's got the wear go version. So you've got the DALI version of this fixture as well for the 5-pole. If you'd like us to do more videos about DALI, it's something we do get asked about from time to time, then drop a comment below.
Got the conductor length there as well. Yeah. Again, a little bit more quality here, isn't there, Gordon?
So these are built from quality components, and what I do notice straight away is the NX symbol both on the driver there itself and on the fixture, which means the product's actually been to a lab to be had its performance validated, and you don't often see that. That's all right doing it on a benchtop, Gary, but I think we now need to validate your performance and see if you can actually fit one in real life. Let's have a look at this fitting you're going to replace, Gary. So this is a very typical twin fluorescent fitting. So this one doesn't have any IP protection specifically, and possibly in this environment it could definitely benefit one, particularly dust.
Yeah, so I'm just going to pop this one out of the way. I'm sure people are now saying, why is that fitting hanging? The floor I'm currently on is going to be removed, so before I need to get in a scissor lifter, I might as well change the fitting itself.
Yeah, so if you, obviously it's got some hazardous waste there. That lamp, check out the video we've made on that if you haven't seen it. Just check that you're getting rid of your fixtures in the right way. So you're going to keep the existing cable from the supply?
Yeah, I'm just going to reroute it. But you can see there, look what we've done previously, a knotted flex through a very large hole. I'm just going to unscrew this and I'm going to reroute it round. You'll see on the back of the fitting how much of the dust has accumulated, and that dust would have also fallen through all the holes in the back of the fitting.
Get rid of that. So we're going to replace it with a fitting. We're going with the 5-foot version of 1500 millimeters If you're from the metric era, it's 46 watts, 6,400 lumens. This range goes from 18 watts, 2,400 lumens, all the way up to 81 watts, which is 11,000 lumens, or a lot of light, and the range is 135 lumens per watt.
Now, them clips that I really like.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you can easily adjust them.
Yeah, so if you're trying to fix those existing positions, yeah, you can just move it along until you've got it hanging in the right place. Oh, what I like there. Gear tray hanging in place. It's not going to, yeah.
And I didn't have to put those in. They were already clipped in place. We all wolves know we're going to bring this out, don't we?
Bit
of ferrule action.
Okay, and screwless terminals.
And again, because the gland was in place, I probably would have come directly into the back. I didn't want to drill another hole into it at this stage, so I'm just going to come into the side position and make my connections off into that Wago connector.
Yeah. So again, this is a DALI version, but we're not using the DALI at this stage, but we may want to add lighting control sensors. You can get sensors that go on the end of fittings if you wanted to have each one locally controlled.
Yeah, press, push, fit, and there is a torque setting for the gland on the end.
Yeah, not often you see that, actually.
No, it's in the instructions.
Mm.
So, most satisfying bit for me, this is.
Feeling the protective layer off the diffuser. So again, that gear tray hanging is a great feature. Just got to clip those back in place.
Yeah, nice firm clips as well. Pop those back into place. This can work in temperatures from minus 25 up to plus 40. And you can see the difference there in that workshop already.
So we've got the 4,000 Kelvin version, 6,500 also available.
Now that was an easy install. Surely it's time for me to pull up a chair and just listen to you wax lyrical now.
I always say you can judge the quality of a light fitting by the amount of data that the manufacturer gives you. And that's specifically with regards to light output and that thing we always talk about, lumen maintenance. That's L70 and L80. If you don't have a clue what that means, we haven't made a separate video about that. But LEDVANCE give you two numbers for this. So it has an L80 of 50,000 hours.
Wow, yeah.
So that's 80% output at 50,000 hours, but they go beyond that. And there's also 70,000 hours to L70. Now, you know, with these being an industry, it's all about that cost of ownership. You want long maintenance cycles. You can improve time between changes, obviously by dimming and things like that. But yeah, LEDVANCE, great that data's there.
And what about colour rendering, Gordon?
Yeah, so again, probably, a lot of applications where colour rendering is important. So this is RA80, so certainly equivalent to a lot of the fluorescent light sources that it's likely to be replacing. And light distribution, obviously you can download lumen output files if you're doing your own lighting design, or it's 110 degrees if you want to have a do a rough estimate of how much where that light's going to go.
It's also IKOA as well.
Yeah, and it is. It's a robust fitting. So, I mean, I like it. I mean, there's a lot of fittings out there that, you know, it's a 4 or a 5 foot version.
Yeah.
Yeah, they all look pretty similar, but it's down to that small specification details that are going to make a difference between if it's a long-lived installation of, and again, keeping the moisture out.
Yeah, and it's that quality that I felt when I was installing it. But as always, we're interested in your comments. Is this a fitting in the past that you've fitted from LEDVANCE? Is it a fitting that you're now thinking about fitting in the future? Please all leave all those comments below, and me and Gordon will try and get back to as many as we can.